I tend to get to know somebody before I tell them about my DBS surgery.
One more tip.
But the kids are really interested to hear about it. Normally there's these leads that go into your brain that stimulate the certain areas through electrical impulse. There's also a chip that can read my brain waves and make adjustments based on my movement needs. It's definitely changed my life.
It's like turning back the clock on Parkinson's disease to give people function, like when their symptoms were very well controlled and mild.
I was a professional skateboarder for a long time, still am skateboarding. And I run a youth skateboard program for kids. Since I'm a skateboarder, you know, I use my body all the time, and it's all about balance. I started looking over my old skate footage that I had, and I started to notice that my hand was starting to cramp. So after that, I went and got checked out, yeah, narrowed it down to PD. I was on this trajectory that was kind of going downhill. I was losing more than I was gaining. What DBS did is it kind of threw a bucket of cold water on my flaming legs. The study that I'm in, it's not just deep brain stimulation where you control your levels, but it's an algorithm that can make the changes before you even know you need them. And that's been the key for me.
DBS is the common acronym for deep brain stimulation. It's basically a brain pacemaker. These devices have to sense brain activity, that's one whole function, and then even more advanced feature is to use that brain activity to control the device. That's what we and others are developing, physiologically guided programming. The world of general clinical neurology is really not quite ready to do adaptive DBS. There's too much to be worked out. But the first stage of this is coming into practice, and that is the brain sensing piece. One wonderful thing about UCSF, we are able to merge clinical treatment with investigational treatment. Not all medical centers are willing to do that.
I guess if anything, the message that I would like to be known for is just about being resilient and just being able to persevere through tough times. I don't really see any other option other than to just keep moving forward.